Hi everyone, this video is about how we can keep our code base or our project, our work safe from AI while using AI. So you have to use AI, because if you don't use AI, then you are endangered in job market. So you have to use AI, but you have to make sure that you don't overuse it and blow up your code base or project. So I'll be talking about that. And this video is continuation of my last video. That was my first video. This is my second video. I'm totally new to YouTube. And my last video has around like 25,000 views, which I expected around 25 or maximum 5 views. So that was very impromptu. I just recorded and just uploaded, and then I found that there was a dip after a few minutes, and I thought it's like something viewers are not interested. So I just deleted that part and later realized it was because of ads. I'm dumb in that case. But yeah, so suppose you're using a coding agent, coding tool like Claude or GitHub Copilot or Cursor. A lot of people are using Cursor. And if you keep writing them, like, please create small prompts, like, please create sign-in page, please create login page, please fix this, make this better, make my code secure. If you do this, that will blow up your project soon. That will blow up your project in like next 5 prompts or after 10 prompts, or you don't even know, but it's happening. It will. So that's where this strategy comes. Creating a control document. You have to create a control.md, means markdown file. And in that markdown file, you have to write your goals, like what you want from AI. What is a project about? Write everything, like what is this project about? Business goal and the technical specification you have in this project. You have to be a product manager, project manager, technical manager, everything for this project. And write in that control document. AI has to know everything. If you're not saying AI, like why I'm creating this project, it can deviate. And I have seen people just accepting what AI is giving and later finding that the project is no more the project they started. So please don't do that. Instead, create that document file, control document file, and write specific scope, specific goal, and the overall picture, overall architecture, and treat AI as the super junior developer, not your manager or not your superior. Treat it as super junior developer who doesn't know anything, who can just like code by copy pasting from Stack Overflow. Think like that. Don't think that it can architect your data pipelines or something like that. If you do that, your data pipeline can be accessed by a 3-year-old guy. I don't know. It could be like how AI is improving. So don't do that. They'll never make architectural decisions or design decision just saying AI, like, just do it. Never do that. If you want to brainstorm using AI, do that. I recommend that. Like, go to ChatGPT and ask to brainstorm with you. Like, if there is something, like you created a data pipeline and you ask ChatGPT how I can improvise this, and then you audit it, then you actually read what ChatGPT is saying and try to understand, and then do the changes. Not like ChatGPT is saying copy paste, not like that. If you do that, then you won't exist in, like, your job won't exist in a few years. AI will replace your job if that happens. If you don't want AI to replace your job, you have to think, because thinking is a practice. If you stop thinking for a few years, you won't be able to think. And AI is just next word predictor. If you have read about AI, it's just the next word predictor. You have to think about that while asking AI what to do, like to implement a code. You have to think about this philosophy. So what else we can add in the control document? We can add about the scope of the files. So you can only change these scopes. You cannot change data structures of this particular file. You can only do like only this module. You have to clear the scopes, and there should be a checklist. This is very important, the checklist part. The control document should have checklist of what task it needs to be done, and the checklist will be having sub features. It's like not even feature, I mean it should be like this: one, feature, sub feature, A, B, C, and two, feature, sub features. So, and if you want to create something, then it should be tagged as something new to be implemented. If you want to fix something, then there should be tag that it should be fixed. But you have to create those checklists when, and ask AI to only complete one checklist at a time. I mean, one point of the checklist at a time. Sub feature tick, and this whole process should be like this. You ask AI to complete this one A. It completes, you test it, you push it. Then one B, then one C. You ask AI. Sorry, I'm new to YouTube and I get a lot of calls, so this distracted me. So yeah,